Hello guys and welcome to another video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you my whole designer handbag collection, and I have brands from LV, Prada, Hermes, Chanel, etc. So if this sounds interesting to you, please keep on watching. I have a lot of designer bags in my collection. Some of them are high-end and some of them are contemporary. And I have some contemporary bags that I'm not going to show you, like my Michael Kors. I have DKNY, Donna Karan New York. I have Lo Moschino and etc. And I don't use them. I have Calvin Klein as well. But the bags I'm gonna show you are bags that I actually wear still. So two of them I'm gonna show you here are more contemporary brands. This is called by Marlene Birger. It's a Danish designer and her logo looks like this. And this brand is actually very famous by the Danish Crown Princess Mary. She's from Australia. But now she's married to the Danish crown prince. So this is looks like the Gucci Soho, but with the strap here as well. But it's way cheaper. But it's made of leather and it's quite durable. And inside it looks like this, with one compartment and a big compartment here. And here it says by Marlene Birger. So this is a summer bag I can wear during the summer when I don't want to have a lot of things in my bag. I want to keep it as light as possible, and it's a great crossbody bag. The next bag I'm going to show you, I haven't used yet. I bought this Coach Tabby bag also as a summer bag, because after becoming a mom, I thought that I needed a bit bigger summer bag than by Marlene Birger. So this is a Coach Tabby with these cute flowers on the white leather. And it's this magnetic closure like this. And inside it's like this burgundy interior. And it has a zip compartment in the middle, but you can't fit a wallet in here because it's too small for that, but you can put some cash and coins if you want to add more security. And it also has a back pocket here. I think you can fit your phone in there. And the next bag is my Senreve bag. Yes, I got sucked in by all the influencers on YouTube who spoke so warmly about this bag, especially Mel in Melbourne. So I decided, when it was a good deal, I decided to pull the plug on it and buy it. So it's the Aria belt bag in this croc embossed leather. It comes with this strap, leather strap. But you can also buy this chain, so you can take instead of the leather strap. And in my deal I got this one for free when I bought the bag. This is actually a practical bag, even though it's in an influencer YouTube bag. It has this magnetic closer like this, and inside you see here there are room for a couple of credit cards. And it's a zipped pocket, and there's also a slip pocket here. The good thing about this, or the practical thing, is that you can both have it as a belt bag, because there are so many holes on the strap that you can have it completely around your body. But you can also wear it as a crossbody bag. So you have both options if you are on holiday, and I thought that was quite practical. And so I'm quite happy with buying this bag, but I won't be buying any more from this brand. Okay, moving on to my next brand, and that is Fendi. I have this Fendi Suka tote, I believe it's called. I bought from a YouTuber called Mary Linda. She had barely used it, and I got a great deal from her. It's inside is like this blue part here with the zipper, and inside is like a big tote bag, and there is a I have this zipped compartment here. It looks much like the Neverfull in a way, and this striped inside stripes in here, and this bag fits quite a lot actually, and it says Fendi Rome in here. So this is my only Fendi bag, at least for now, but I quite like this tote, and the handles are so long that you can have it nicely on your shoulder. And then I have this hobo bag from Prada, which I bought a sale. I bought it from a sale in a store that in Norway that's a lot longer open. And this is Prada bag. It's a purple color, and here you have the famous Prada interior, and it has a zipped compartment here where you can put maybe your phone or a wallet or something. I haven't used this in a while, but I'm not gonna sell it. First of all, purple bag is not so easy to sell, and it's practical to have one hobo bag in my collection, and it's quite comfortable on the shoulder, and you see the strap is a bit adjustable with these three holes here. So I'll start off with my Totally MM Damier Eben that I bought from the LV store in Palma de Mallorca when I was on a cruise a few years ago. This is a very practical bag because it has the pockets here, and they have pocket here. You can have your bottle of lemonade when you're on holiday. And if you look inside the bag, I have an organizer from Zamorga. But as you can see, it doesn't fit correctly, because back here it's like this extra room. It should be in like this, but it doesn't. So it's like two slips here for a lemonade bottle or something else. Other than that, you have this slip compartment. Sorry, try better here, back there. And on the other side, you have also two zip slip compartment here, where you can put stuff, and it also has a D-ring where you can hook your keys. Moving on, I have a Diana MM. That was released after the Totally MM was discontinued. This is the Damier Azur print, and it was supposed to be my summer bag, but I haven't gotten around to use it yet. And you have this light vaquetta, as you see here, and it has this pocket on the front where you can put your phone, and you see it's like this pink interior. I think it's the maybe it's the Rose Ballerine. And you have the leather chap made in Paris. Inside, I have an organizer from Zamorga in this bright pink. It comes with a D-ring, as you can see here. And other than that, it has a compartment here on the back, just like the Totally. So it's like it's a little sister. And it also has then two compartments here on the back, also just like the Totally. So So this is very much the same size bag also, but it totally has this slip pocket on the outside, and Deanna does not. So yeah, no feet. Moving on, I have my Alma BB in Devonie leather in the Amaran color. Comes with the gold hardware and it has feet on the bottom. And it comes with a strap, but the strap is not adjustable. So that's something to keep in mind if you're petite. And inside, it has this my lock. It has this big compartment here. And there also a small silly pocket in the back, but it can't fit much. I bought this preload, but it was hardly used. So yeah. And yeah, and I just show you, I forgot to mention, I got it from the store in Oslo, but they shipped it to me. Moving on, I have my Twist MM in the Galet color, and we have this twist turn lock. And if you open the bag, it just has big compartment here and a slip compartment here. And it also come with the mirror, so you can check if your makeup is fine. This was supposed to be a present to myself for being pregnant and giving birth later on to my now 1-year-old daughter. So this is an epi leather, and it's a quite a durable bag. No feet. I have actually the first LV bag that I bought and didn't sell, and this is my Speedy 30 in the Damira Ben, the bandolier version. I also bought this preload from Couture USA, because back then I didn't know that you can order from the store in Oslo. I lived up north in Norway, so I thought, okay, this is my only option, I have to buy it preload. But it was like in almost in new condition, nothing wrong with it. And I have an organizer from Zamorga inside. And besides from that, this is an old version of the Speedy. Now it has a pocket with a zipper, but back then it didn't, so it is a slit pocket here. And it also comes with, yeah, the D-ring, where I have attached this chain to have my wallet easily accessible, or my keys, when I have much stuff in the bag, so I can find it easily. And this is bought from eBay, it's not from LV in itself. This is my most used handbag. I always use it when I'm visiting my mother. And I also wear it when I'm out shopping from time to time. So I really love the Speedy bandolier. And my last LV bag is this LV Retiro in the monogram, and you have the Vachetta leather that has this nice patina, and you see it also has feet on the bottom. I bought this preload because I wanted the old version of this bag. In the new version, the strap here is quite a bit longer. So for me, when I want to have it as a shoulder bag, that's not possible. So I thought, okay, then I had to buy preload to get the shorter strap, because I tried the new version on in the store and I didn't like it. I could wear it across body, but it was impossible to wear it on the shoulder because the strap was too long. I don't have an organizer in here, but it looks like they had the same pockets. You see the slip pocket about as the Speedy. You can have stuff here, and the other side it has two compartments here, and it also comes with the D-ring. Yeah, it was not too easy to show. I think you see it there, yeah. And it has this velvet material on the inside. It did come with a few pen marks on the side. But other than that, it was in very good condition. And what's inside the bag, I don't mind, because no one will see it anyway. Moving on to Chanel. This was actually my third Chanel bag. I sold the two other ones, my GST and my Medallion Tall, because I decided to invest in a classic flap. And I'm very glad I did, because when I bought this, it was $6,000 and now it's $9,200. So that's an increase of more than 50% in 5 years. The Maxi is a huge big bag, but I like big bags, and I'm 5'9 about around that, so I don't think it's too heavy for me to wear. Of course, I don't wear a full size wallet in here, because it gets heavy quite easily, but if you don't stuff it too much, you don't have any problems. And it has this back pocket here, the Mona Lisa smile. This is in the caviar leather with the silver hardware. And it has this, it's the double flap. And it has the secret compartment. And as you know, the burgundy interior with two slip pockets and one in the middle for your lipstick. And it also is a compartment here in the front. And also this secret compartment back here. And I've used my Chanel Maxi a few times, and I really enjoy that bag. This is another one I exchanged my Pochette Matisse from LV, because I didn't use that bag, so I decided to swap it for this Chanel Walk instead. This is the 15 series, so it's quite a few years old, and it's in the lambskin, pink lambskin. And inside you see the pocket here, and this is actually the bag I use when I am shopping, because then I just need my phone and I need my cards, and then everything is fine. And it also has this pockets on the back. So this is a very much used bag of mine that is very practical. And then is my newest handbag. This is the Chanel 19 in the large size, and it is in a lambskin. This lambskin is more durable than the regular classic flap lambskin, but as I can see here, move the video, I don't know if you can see it, that's a hash, a small scratch here, but I guess that's expected when you have lambskin. It is a top handle bag and also comes with a strap. Both the strap and the handle is actually quite heavy, so that's something to keep in mind. And it has this back pocket with the magnetic closure. And on the front you see the lock here, the gold lock with this woven leather. And you open it up. Oops. It's a single flap here. And I've had an organizer from Zamorga inside to keep the shape of the bag better. So it looks like this, but it still has this zipped compartment in the back where you can put your wallet or something else. I haven't only worn this once because of COVID, but now we're getting outside again, I will definitely wear this more. This is like a casual everyday bag, although it's from Chanel. And lastly, my Hermes handbag. This is my Evelyn in the PM size, in the 29 centimeters, and I have this organizer from Sumuni inside. So it's an organizer for the big compartment here, Other than that, it will be just a big hole and it's impossible to find anything. So I had this in the contrast colors with easy to find things. And the other pocket I have another organizer. If you buy one for Evelyn 29, you get two organizers instead of one. And this compartment is the one who's supposed to be, you wear it like this on the outside, but if you wear it like this, you have the security of having your phone in the small compartment next to your body, so it won't get stolen if you're afraid of pickpockets. So this feels actually quite secure because you can have it so close to your body. And this is in the Clémence leather in the taupe color. And I haven't worn these also because of COVID, but now we're getting outside again, I'll definitely will. There we have it, guys. That was my handbag collection as of today. And maybe in the future I will add some more bags, but right now I'm quite satisfied with the ones I've got. And I just have to start using them more and go outside. Okay, guys, I'll see you in my next video. And until then, take care. Bye-bye.